remember what?
To deliver to you this precious paper that the president
have
elected to the Federal Republic of Nigeria's Red Chambers. We are most grateful.
PDP! That is the manner way of Pastor Bennett.
Yes.
One and two.
Let
me recognize and appreciate members of the State House of Assembly, commissioners, members of the State Executive Council who are here, top government functionaries, chairman of local governments here. I would like to particularly, with a depth of appreciation, recognize members of the Campaign Council, the Director General of the campaign, and all those the deputy directors who are here, the campaign coordinators at local government level, campaign coordinators at the ward levels, agents, up to unit agents, up to community coordinators. And now, let me also turn back to the party. The state chairman, our chairman Burugu, and all members of the state working committee of our party. His Excellency, the governor of our state, my worthy successor, and His Excellency, the deputy governor, who is his reliable ally and partner. From my own house. Amen. I want to appreciate all of you, community leaders, traditional and opinion and political leaders, religious leaders, but most importantly, all of you registered voters of this great senatorial district. Anwar! You know, before I render
your head,
my first senatorial speech. And you are going to hear this voice a great deal.
Yes.
That's why a supporter who printed this card said I must wait while I was while addressing it with this evening. You know, all power flows through. God has been so merciful. God has been so forgiving. God has been so loving. And particularly for me, for my family, and for our people and all of us. Not so. So, before I render my speech, just one chorus. You are the mighty God. You are the great God.
I love you.
Wonderful people, leaders of our states, leaders of our party, leaders of this senatorial district, leaders of our communities, and all of you across the length and breadth of our senatorial district who turned out en masse in all your units and voting points, in all our communities, and even voting across parties. Today, this victory is dedicated to God Almighty and to you all.
Yeah.
The good and wonderful people of our senatorial district. The good and wonderful people of the John Nation. The good and wonderful people of Bayelsa. I am aware that this mandate is not just a mandate for Bayelsa West. I'm aware that this is a mandate to support and galvanize our state for the right causes. I'm aware that this is a mandate to do the same for the John Nation. I'm aware that this also entails a mandate. Working with our allies and friends and colleagues across the length and breadth of our nation to advance and deepen our democracy in this country. Well, let me briefly highlight what I think will form the main focus for the remainder of the legislative period that I'm going to serve as your senator. As you are aware, this country is collapsing. As you are aware, Nigeria's structure is lopsided, and the way this federation is structured cannot promote unity, cannot promote productivity. And that is why we have always, as a people, made a clarion call for devolution, otherwise called restructuring. And so, that, you all know, will form a major part of what I'm going to do in the Senate. And I won't be able to do that alone. So, on your behalf, I will be building new bridges of understanding. Consolidating on bridges already built. And our leaders and forefathers, even before independence, have done a lot of good work. So our pathway is clear. But we are going to talk to all our allies and friends and all those who mean well within the Senate, within the National Assembly, and even outside. All critical stakeholders must realize what has become a national imperative. Restructuring Nigeria is a task that must be done. And so we are not going to stop talking about it. We are going to argue for it. We are going to explain the content of it. We are going to contact and consult all those people of goodwill from across all parties and all regions so that we can salvage our country together. That means a profound constitutional re-engineering, a constitutional reform of our country. Second, electoral reforms. We must deepen our democracy. Today we have seen how the voices of our people have been heard. But a few months ago, in this same state, you all saw how our mandate was stolen, almost stolen. Our people were not allowed to vote, our communities were invaded, our voices were suppressed. And as someone who has managed this state for the first time in opposition since 2015, I know what we have gone through. I know the trauma that our people have suffered innocent people, law-abiding people, just going out to exercise their democratic rights and freedoms, have been subjected to all kinds of harassment and intimidation and trauma. So we are going to push for electoral, genuine electoral reforms.
Yes.
At this point, I would like to commend the acting chairman and all the officials, the resident electoral commissioner, and all his officials who conducted this exercise. This is a marked departure from what we have been seeing in our recent electoral past in this state. But we need to build consensus on how to further deepen electoral reforms to make INEC truly independent and to make it possible for security agencies to also at all times perform their duties in a professional manner that they have done today. I would like also at this point to appreciate all the security officials, the military officials who supported the escort of materials, the police, the civil defense, and all the security forces that came together to deliver this very credible result and process. Now, you all know that we are victims of what I've always called environmental terrorism as a people, at the hands of the oil majors and at the hands of federal institutions that are not structured to perform their duties of protecting our people. Our rivers and waterways and creeks are all polluted, and the polluters are allowed to go scot-free. They are allowed to do things here that they can never be allowed to do in their own home countries. And now, they have not only been polluting, they are now sponsoring hoodlums in the likeness and image of surveillance contractors terrorizing and killing and maiming our own people. All these are issues that we will, working with our allies and friends, address. And this is in addition to attracting necessary development from the center to augment and support what the state is doing and will continue to do. As someone who has had the honor and privilege of serving as your governor for 8 years, I know the pains. I know what governors struggle with, particularly in an economy that is now officially declared to be once again in recession. I managed a state in a recession for 5 years. And so at this point, this state needs all hands on deck, particularly from our indigenous and our friends at the federal level, who can bring necessary support to advance our development, to support what the state had been doing, to support what this new governor will also be doing. So these are what will form the cornerstone of our legislative agenda. In no distant time, I will assemble the campaign council to formally thank you all, and assemble the leadership of the party to thank you all. This is a complete demonstration of confidence. This is a complete rejection of the APC in this senatorial district.
Amen.
This is a further confirmation of the unity and solidarity of this senatorial district. Your votes in all the units. And I understand that my opponent was only able to, I think he tried to win only his ward.
No,
it's only his unit. It's unit. So which means he lost his ward.
Yes. Yes. Difference of 9.
With a difference of 9, at least he won.
Yes.
So I think he won his unit with 9 votes. Which is not bad. Which is not bad. But he lost his ward. Lost his community. Lost his unit. Lost his local government. Well, his father said, no problem. His father is a nice man. It's our father too. And Lee is a nice man. Anyway, but today, our people have spoken. And what I want to tell my former opponent, from this point, there's no opponent. is now once again my constituent.
Yes, sir.
Is to say that it's welcome back to the fold.
Yeah. Exactly.
Thank you.
Yes.
It's welcome back to the fold.
We'll bring him back.
Our big umbrella is big enough to accommodate him. Your PDP is his own party. And not only him, although the few people, very few, in this editorial district who were with him, the PDP has room for all of you.
Yeah.
And as you all know, our brand of politics is politics without bitterness.
Yeah, no.
Come back, my brothers. Come back, my brothers. We'll work together for the success of our people.
Yeah.
Tonight, I think what I've said is enough.
Yes.
I just want to thank you again and again.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
All of you for the sleepless nights.
Yeah.
Campaign Council.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, too good.
PDP!
So I want to thank you all, and in no distant time, like I said, we'll be meeting.
Thank you,
and let all our people know that this is ushering in a new lease of unity in this senatorial district, which all will see. Thank you very much, and God bless you all.
PDP is not interested in excluding APC and Ebedu from election. No. Our interest is to see that APC and Ebedu on Saturday are defeated completely, rejected totally.
Yes.
Now, is it a plan, that the baby will win?
Not for me.
Is it a plan? With all the leaders totally behind PDP and totally supporting me,
99%.
Is it plan that he will win?
No way.
Okay. Go to Ndoro. His mother is from there. Late mother.
From
here, sir. Can he win Ndoro?
No.
Okay. Go to Ekeremotown.
No way. Ekeremotown is 99%. No way. No people, no APC in
Ekeremotown.
No go area.
No go area. No go area.
We will be lucky to score 20% of
no go area. Ekeremoye! Ekeremoye! Ekeremoye!